Satu, dua, tiga, action! Okay, what is up guys? Farhan here and with Zah once again. And here I have Syam. How are you, man?
Brother. Very good, man.
And he's the owner of Orange Plus. I just got to know. Alamak, I was like so honored, you know. well-recognized back ambulance company. And very, very honored to have him. And we have his wife, Reni, the owner of this ADV150. And I just want to say, when I first saw this bike on social media, I fell in love with it.
It's for G-Shock fans.
I don't even like G-Shock, and I fell in love with the design.
Yeah, I mean the livery is very attractive. No, it's black and pink is a very brave color to play around with.
Yes.
Black and pink,
and to bring around in Singapore, bro.
Oh my god, when these pictures were on social media on Facebook, there were many shares. You know. People are sharing this, going crazy over this, man. And thank you for, you know, last minute thing. I contacted him actually, and he agreed to review the bike lah.
Anything for the bikers community, bro.
Yeah.
Okay, so we are going to give a little bit of background on the Honda ADV 150. Launched during the 2018 Gaikindo Indonesia International Auto Show, the ADV 150 is marketed as an on-road adventure scooter. Described as a cross between the PCX and the African Twin, its inspiration comes from the bigger brother, the XADV, a scaled-down version. So the ADV 150 is packed with technology, with the angular styling and design to match. Its rival is the Yamaha NMAX 155. So engine is shared with the PCX 150. It's a 149cc SOHC single cylinder with a liquid cooled engine and a V-belt automatic transmission. So here in Singapore, the ADV 150 is slowly gaining ground in the Class 2B scene. Okay, so we have mentioned about the decals, and I just want to ask, what is the inspiration behind the Casio team ADV?
The reason why I choose G-Shock is because G-Shock has been in our lives, I think, for us, most of us young.
Since I was secondary school, we already have G-Shock.
Yeah. I think your first watch should be, most of us, our first watch should be G-Shock. I think back in the days where it's Baby G ke apa ke kan. So we all start from G-Shock. So then plus there's no bike, let's say in Singapore, you are having this G-Shock decal. So that's our first step on taking G-Shock to another level. Plus bring up the more to show more about G-Shock community lah, to grow more on it. Then to put it on the bike. Bro, aku sendiri surprise lah ni benda.
What was your reaction bila gambar-gambar, sorry, English. Yeah. What was your reaction when those pictures on Facebook went viral?
I can say I did not expect it to be so viral. I think the reason why it get viral is, I think, because of G-Shock. Okay, it's not because of the bike, it's just because of the design. And basically it's G-Shock and Casio lah. So everybody can relate to it. You know, like G-Shock and Casio, everybody. Yeah, for me, it's an unexpected thing to get viral lah.
But I think this G-Shock team design is a very good so-called linking, you know, because the ADV has been marketed as an adventure scooter.
Yeah.
So it is just appropriate that you have a G-Shock brand, G-Shock team to match the ruggedness of this bike.
And not only that, this bike angular design looks like a G-Shock, so
fits the decal.
So why did you buy the ADV in the first place?
I know that Rene is actually riding lah, but I think
firstly Rene bike going to scrap Wave 125. So in other ways, I also want to own an ADV 150. So in other ways, I cycle her to get ADV 150.
Because I wasn't particular lah. I mean, I just wanted a simple bike for commuting back. I mean, from home to work basically. Yeah. I know nothing about bikes, so I rely on Syam to make the decision for me.
Yep. Oh, but this bike when it first came out, I was like, wow, I fell in love. You know, the design is lawa.
Yeah.
Like his big brother, the 750.
Yes.
So I think. Because of the presence of the 750, the big brother, so when they came out the 150, the motorcycle scene was a buzz, you know. Even in my CB180X group, right, they also were talking about this bike. In fact, if this bike had came out earlier, I would have bought this bike instead of CB180X.
Correct. And then I read somewhere that it actually outsold the GS for a while. Yeah, in Europe.
That's cool, man.
plus it has compatible with the Aerox.
You mean the 150?
Yes, the 150, yeah. Not the older sibling.
Ah, okay, that's cool.
What's the price when you guys bought this bike?
At
that time,
the price I think is about
14k
with the COE.
Yeah, with the new COE.
Yeah. 7k lah. Kira kan, that time the current COE 7k lah.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
7,000.
I'm so sorry, guys. I cannot buy a bike right now. That's expensive for me, but yeah.
We couldn't wait.
What was the fuel consumption like? You know,
the fuel consumption for us. I rode it once. No, I rode it twice. Mm-hmm. In fact, then I was actually quite surprised with the fuel consumption. I think it's on par with FZ16. Okay, so I've been riding FZ16 for my class 2B bike. Mm-hmm. Then for me it's on par with it because the fuel consumption for 2B is not bad. Full tank can maybe bring you up to 300 kilos to maybe 350 or max like that.
Okay, yeah. What's the full tank capacity?
I think about 5 liters, bro, can't remember.
Serious?
Yeah,
5 to 6.
Uh-huh. 5 to 6? Yeah. For 300 kilometers is...
The reason why I save 4 to 5 because I didn't pump the bike. Okay, it's the lady.
Yeah, I pumped, so it's about 6. Yeah.
So for you, for 6 liters can bring you 300 kilometers. That's very impressive, you know.
You're tempting me to buy this bike.
Right now, the motorcycle scene, a lot of the scooters, you know, sport scooters. Yeah. We have the Aerox, we have the NMAX, we have the Gilera's, and we have this ADV. Yeah. So, you know, it's bustling with scooters, so sometimes I will be tempted to take this one for its design because of, you know, for the travel that we do, because we go on overland touring, this bike would fit the description.
The fuel consumption.
The fuel consumption is. But I like the Gilera for its speed.
Yep.
And its torque.
But Gilera already out of fashion already, bro. Now nobody ride Gilera. That was 4-5 years ago story.
Okay, but if you're in Malaysia, if you ride a Gilera in Malaysia, you are a rich person, you know. Okay, so far, how long have you ride this bike?
I think less than a month, bro.
Oh, less.
Less than a month. Wow. Yeah.
So
no issues lah.
There will be no issues lah.
The only issues I have is, you know, my weight is. So the front fork and the rear suspension is shitty, bro. Shitty. Even though they state show on the suspension at the back, okay, but shit, bro. Very, very shit.
Okay. So the issues for you is because of your size, yep, and then the suspension cannot
uphold my weight.
Ah, I see. Okay. But among the ADV riders in the community in Singapore right now, did they like share with you any problems or any technical issues with this bike?
Basically, it's just the suspension. For other than the performance wise, nothing so far. Even when I do my own towing, I never towed this bike before unless flat tires. But the issues, the main issues is they always say once your bike is out from the workshop or from the shop, you have to do your front fork and your rear suspension.
So is the suspension a quick fix that you guys change to aftermarket? It should be okay?
Bro, looking at the rate of the aftermarket parts for ADV 150, spoiled for choices, bro. For the rear suspension, we have the Bitobo, then we have the YSS, we have the Olin's, then the front also as well with the YSS, Olin's, fork kit. Oh, bro, spoiled for choices, bro.
So can say this bike is macam a Lego bike already lah.
Lego bike lah, bro. Lego bike. Yeah. Can say, bro.
We can already see that you have already put this side crash.
Yeah, crash bar.
Crash bar.
Yep.
And then other than that, he changed the radiator cover.
Basically, there's so much accessories for this bike. You know, just like the Aerox, it's available in Malaysia, Indonesia, Thailand. So if you have the bikes available in either one of these three countries, right? Your choice of accessories is
a lot.
You're spoiled for choice. Unlike my bike, that's not available in Malaysia and Thailand.
Bike also very sad, right?
So we don't have much choices for aftermarket accessories. So if you guys are the type who likes to mod and accessorize your bikes, this bike has a lot of accessories today.
Whatever you see here, you just want 8 of the accessories.
It's
just one thing on accessories.
I can foresee you'll be, you know, spending a lot of money on this.
No, bro.
Like, don't tempt yourself.
This is just good enough, sir.
This is good enough already. Yeah, I agree. How's the handling like? I mean, is it nimble in traffic?
Handling wise, I think really can explain more.
Yeah, for me, like, because I rode a very light bike, right? Yeah. 125 is like bicycle like that. So when I first got this bike, I had to adapt to its weight. I think for me,
it's quite heavy for you.
It's quite heavy. I'm not sure whether this is like a standard for other to be bikes, but I had to struggle lah. Like usually, if I want to reverse, right, I can sit on the bike, but because I'm short. So usually for this bike, if I have to reverse out a lot, right, I have to like dismount and I have to push it. So like it requires a lot of strength for me. Then I'm also short. So at 157, like I cannot like plant my foot fully. So I have to tiptoe. So that's like a challenge for me lah.
I see. But you adapted that after a few days?
After a few days it's okay lah. Then like in terms of the steering also for me, I feel it's very smooth. Like for a to be bike, like usually you know when you take to be bike, right, whatever potholes and whatever bumps on the road you can feel. But for this bike, I don't know, maybe for me the suspension is okay. But for me like it can absorb, like I'm not like bumping all the time when I'm on the road.
So currently is the rear suspension setting at its fullest or
It's fixed, bro.
It's fixed.
Oh yeah, it's fixed. You can't adjust it or
so that explains the shitty rear suspension.
Yeah, shitty feeling, bro.
So much for the technical aspect. How much did it cost you for the design, the decals, everything?
The design, decals, everything. Okay, for the design and the decals, it cost us about
$800.
$800. Yeah.
The accessories, the guards, all that.
Accessories, I think, is about $180.
Yeah. Okay. Not sponsored, lah. But where you guys do the decals?
Okay, this is not a sponsored post, but.
Even G-Shock also not sponsoring. Yeah, yeah.
So nothing on this bike is sponsored.
So please sponsor us.
Okay, so the decals was done at CS Graphics by the man himself, Man Lambat, in Facebook name. So you guys can check it out. He got tons of beautiful designs. So the reason why I go to him is from the first bike I have until I think 7 bikes already I own. Most of my decals done by him. Even my company vans, lorries, everything all done by him.
I see. So guys, if you want to have your customized decal designed for your bike, just there's the link down there. There's the link down
there. Not sponsored, once again, I'm not sponsored.
Man, sponsor them, man. These two, man.
Yes. Sponsor us, please.
Man, sponsor, man. Kita feature kau dalam vlog nanti. So Rene, I know you are the main rider for this ADV.
Yeah.
So, what's the best memories you have so far, walaupun dah satu bulan, walaupun 1 month?
Not even 1 month lah. But I think the best memory I had will probably be like this is my third bike. But it is the first bike that I actually took like professional photos of it. Like previously my two bikes, right, when I wanted to sell it off before the COE expired, like Syam was asking me, hey, you got picture of bike or not? And I had zero photos of my bike. Like nobody knew what bike I rode at all, because like, you know, it wasn't something to show off lah. But this bike is like so beautiful that macam, you know, like it's, I don't know, I'm quite obsessed with it. So my best memory is definitely the reveal, because like Syam didn't tell me that it was ready. So he just showed up, and then after that he was like, hey, it's ready, you know. So I was like pleasantly surprised, because all I requested for was pink and he got it. Then I requested for mint. So basically I just sit back, relax and wait for the magic to happen lah. So will you guys be showing the features? Because I think some of the
yes,
the decals are like pretty sweet. So
it is sweet.
So gives me motivation lah to merayap more.
Okay guys, if you guys happen to see this bike on the road, just say hi. Okay?
Don't sembong.
Yeah, you won't be seeing me lah. You seeing her more often.
But if your bike break down, you'll be seeing.
Okay, so final question we're gonna ask. As you know, this is a 2B, so definitely 2B riders will have their eye on it lah. Yep. And do you think this is a suitable bike for them after passing out from driving school as a starter bike?
Honestly, if you have no intention of upgrading to 2A or 2 Class 2, then yes, because it is automatic. Like you don't have gears and everything, so it's very easy for you. You don't have to stress yourself with gears and clutches. So 2B bikes, like no intention of upgrading, yes. But if you have intention to upgrade, then maybe for fun lah, or for a while can. But for me, I'm like a long term kind of rider, so for me it's good enough. Yeah.
Yeah. Same lah. I would be riding my CB180X until it expires.
Yeah.
I rode Hidayah for 7 years already. So.
Yeah. So.
Okay lah. So guys, thank you so much for featuring your ADV that went viral.
No problem.
Thank you for having us.
Oh my gosh. And then next we're going to review Syam's BMW
GS.
Sampah bro, that
one. Bye bye. We will share his story.
So if you guys like this video, just click subscribe, share and like our videos. And if and a shout out to the Honda ADV 750 guys. If you have anyone that is interested to share with us your stories and review your bike, just contact us.
Yes.
Everything is down in the link.
Do support them, guys. We need more of these kind of reviews in Singapore so that to help fellow riders in the future to get their own bikes. Okay? With more bikes review, better choice for you guys to get a bike. Okay?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we'll see you next one.